Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Tech Edge. As we get ready for the release of Windows 11, hardware requirements have been a popular topic of conversation. If you haven't seen our video about TPM, be sure to check that out because one of the things we mentioned was changing settings in the BIOS. Today, I wanted to talk about the difference between BIOS and UEFI, and while you'll also need to make sure you're using UEFI if you plan to install Windows 11. The terms BIOS and UEFI are often used interchangeably, but in reality, they are two different generations of firmware-based computer instructions. BIOS, which stands for Basic Input Output System, is the older of the two instruction sets. In 2007, BIOS was largely supplanted by UEFI, which stands for Unified Extensible Firmware Interface. UEFI offers a few major advantages over BIOS, including enhanced security features, but many UEFI motherboards still offer BIOS support while in legacy mode. Microsoft has decided to leverage the advances of UEFI in Windows 11 in order to offer enhanced security for users. This means that Windows 11 must run in UEFI and is not compatible with BIOS or legacy compatibility mode. When checking to see if your PC is Windows 11 capable, you must also enable Secure Boot, which is a UEFI-only feature. Now, you can check your Windows install mode before enabling Secure Boot by searching for the System Information app in the search bar and checking your BIOS mode setting. If your system reports that it is in UEFI mode, then you're good to go. If it doesn't report being in UEFI mode, then you're in a mode not supported by Windows 11. If you switch over to UEFI at this point, your operating system won't boot due to the hard drive being in legacy boot mode instead of UEFI. It's always a good idea to document your BIOS or UEFI settings before changing them in case you need to revert those settings later. If you didn't document your settings changes and your computer no longer boots, don't panic. You can still reset your system back to legacy mode. If you're using an OnLogic computer, you can refer to our support site and find the appropriate motherboard manual for your system and follow the instructions there. Now, the big takeaway here is that your system will need to be set to UEFI to install Windows 11. If you've been using legacy mode in Windows 10, you'll need to switch to UEFI and then do a fresh install of Windows 10 before trying to upgrade to Windows 11. As we mentioned in our TPM video, this could all still change. We're months away from Windows 11 making its debut, and Microsoft will continue to evaluate hardware requirements as they release the new OS to their Windows insiders and partner OEMs like OnLogic. We'll keep you updated, so if you found this video helpful, be sure to subscribe and give this video a like. You can find a few helpful links related to Windows 11 and UEFI in the description. But if you still have questions, leave them in the comments and we'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Tech Edge.